Okay, here's my weekly update on my aquaponic system. I've done some new planting this week and I added a lemon ice cube a couple of days ago. That seems to have made some positive difference to the plants. I'll go over all of that just now. The sponge gourd still coming out over here. Started to flower a little bit that you can make out up there. It's put out these four flowers since yesterday, really. They weren't there yesterday. Here's it going along. And yeah, there's a couple of flowers there. There's another couple of flowers that have been chomped on by the birds. Yeah, right there. See, birdie's been having a meal there, so those flowers aren't going to set anything. But again, this one new stem that's coming out seems to have this one that you can see in the middle that's thicker than the rest. I figure this may be the fruit-bearing stem. Corn here doing well again, hasn't put out more than two of these flower stems, but nice and tall, nice and strong, and the fruit is coming along quite nicely and fatly. Yeah, right there, see, it's coming along, and the other one is also putting out a little fruit right here. Yeah, the third one not doing much though, even though it's been given a little bit of support, it hasn't. It's put out a little bit over here, you know, this is a bit of touch of its, like half of that is new growth, but otherwise it's nothing much. The basil coming along nicely as always. Some of the older leaves getting this burn thing on the outside, I think they've just been in there for too long and really need to be harvested. Today I think I'm going to go over the sweet basil and the Thai basil a little bit, and I'm going to make myself some pesto out of it. Here's the oregano, doing nicely, spreading out. I'm pretty sure the roots of this are really getting invasive to the siphon and all. The mint that got harvested a few days ago again is doing all right, nice and green, nice and long, all the way down there. In fact, right down here is where it hits its length. The berry tree getting a bit squished by the corn and the basil, but it's doing fine, you know, lots of growing heads popping up all over the place, and it's doing quite well. No flowering or anything on it though, as yet. The cucumbers have taken off, they've got nice and turgid, nice and steady, loud, strong leaves. They've still got a bit of trouble with this leaf miner issue, I've been trimming it past couple of days, I've left these two to be. This one is also doing just fine. What's exciting though, and the gardener confirms this, is that that is a little cucumber leaf flower, and is going to set some fruit there. There's a couple of these, one over there, and there's one somewhere here as well. Anywho, so yeah, they're coming out, and there's a couple of them on the dirt ones that these got transplanted out of as well, so it'll be interesting to see if these mature in the next couple of days into some cucumbers. The lemon tree is about the same, not really seeing a lot of growth on this. I mean, the same old leaves are there, there's no new shoots or anything coming out, so that's strange. The tomatoes, again, these are also having the same leaf miner issues, and I'm trying to just, you know, trim out the leaves that get infected, but I don't think that's a very good thing. I want to put on a chili garlic and sea salt tea mixture today on all of them, just to see if I can if I can get them to stop, and so I can stop trimming my nice tomato flowers right here. That's how they're doing. There's that cucumber in the back that came out of seed. It flowered in a very different way from these cucumbers. It's the only one left now. I pulled the other ones because they weren't doing so well. They're just taking up space. Here's a little red cabbage that I just put in, I think about 5 odd minutes ago. I'm not sure if I've done a very good job transplanting that, but yeah, it's in the system now. It's quite loose and it can move around and shit. The seedling here, right there at the bottom, is again, it's just struggling. It's not really doing anything. And the seedlings over there, right there, are also just struggling and not really doing anything. Here's some peas that I just transplanted. There's 5 of these pea plants, just one of that red cabbage. There's 5 of them. I put them in the corner here and I figure I'll grow them out up and over the side and make full use of my vertical space. The fish are doing nicely. They're settling into their new food, which is a hikari staple diet for goldfish. And they're Yeah, they're all right with it. Not quite as excited as they were with their older food, but they go at it in a satisfactory manner when the temperature is all right. They've only been fed once so far today. They're going to get another feeding soon. Yeah, they all hang out at the bottom now. They're very aware of when they're going to be fed and when they're not going to be fed. Just being filmed right now, so they're just dashing around. You can see those strange colors on them because the water is still flowing and there's quite a bit of surface movement on the water here. So, yeah, that's why they look a little freaky. But, yeah, they're quite large now, fun to look at, fun to feed. They're staying alive as well, so that's actually quite a bit of... that really adds to the fun factor of it all. Yeah, and it's nice and clean. See, I gave it a bit of a scrub, missed a couple of spots here and there, but otherwise it's nice and clean now. All of that stuff on the side of the fish tanks is gone. Here is the sump tank. This also got a bit of a scrubbing. Again, it's a spot or two here or there that's left, and the cichlids inside, you really can't make them out, but there are still six of them, quite happy, quite tense feeding, quite happy. I had a couple of issues with my siphon past day or so, but I think I managed to work around them and it's pretty much done. The water tests I've been doing have also been giving good solid results at 0, 0 and 12.5 milligrams per liter for ammonia, nitrite and nitrate. So yeah, that's all quite a positive to do. And I think the lemon cube is working out. I'm going to see past couple of days if these flowers open out, and then once they stop I'll put in another lemon cube. And hopefully that will help out the whole thing. Now, some more planting on the dirt end as well. Here's some more sponge gourds that were put in to just to refresh these vines, which are seemingly not going to be getting to the end of their fruiting cycle. There's a big fruit that it's developing, and up there, you can just make out there's some more fruit that it's starting to set and starting to get in over there, right there, yeah. And here's the other big round fruit that's been developing. Yeah, so that's how the dirt sponge gourds are doing. And there's some of the dirt corn also setting and coming along. Here's other bits of the dirt corn also coming along quite nicely and quite steadily. Things have just been moved around a little bit. There's the coriander coming along quite happily and healthily. Here's some here's what's left of the radish. The radish has all got harvested. Some cherry tomato plants that are going in. Here's some more red cabbage that my red cabbage came from. It's all getting transplanted as we speak. Some more tomatoes that have been put in. Some more tomatoes that have been put in. All pink tomatoes that have been taken out of there. Single ETBT little grow beds and put into here, planters and put into here. Yeah, so lots of action on the dirt. And some peas that's left. I took one complete jar of peas out, and let's see if we can get a close up on the bugs that are on my corn in the dirt at least. Yeah, it's just no doing. I think you can just make it out that there's some bugs there. Yeah, and there's green ones and there's little white ones. I'm not sure really which ones are the good ones and which ones are the bad ones. There's a whole bunch of them there as well. Hopefully my spray right now will take care of these. So yeah, that's how everything's going, you guys. And let me know how you guys think I should be tackling these pests better, if there's any other way that you guys can think of. So thanks for watching, you guys. Take care.